Hey there, scientists! Caroline here, and welcome to a brand new unit of Environmental Science 2. Have you ever heard the name Guy Callender? Probably not. He wasn't a famous scientist or explorer. He was a steam engineer in England in the 1930s. But during his free time, he did something that changed how we understand Earth's climate. Callender gathered temperature records from over 100 weather stations, and after months of calculations, he discovered something surprising. The planet had warmed by about 0.3 degrees Celsius over the previous 50 years. And even more surprising, Callender believed these changes were the direct result of human activity. At the time, most people, including scientists, dismissed his ideas. How could human activity possibly change something as massive as Earth's climate? In today's lesson, we're going to explore this mystery. Ready, scientists? Let's get started. Before we dive in, remember, climate is not the same as weather. Weather is like what you're wearing today. It's happening right now. Climate is like all the clothes in your closet. It has to do with patterns over a long time. So when we talk about climate change, we're talking about a long-term change in Earth's average weather patterns, such as temperature, rainfall, and storms. Guy Callender's theory? Climate change on Earth is largely influenced by a specific human activity, burning fossil fuels. His reasoning was based on something we now call the greenhouse effect. This is a natural process where carbon dioxide and other gases in the atmosphere trap some of the heat from the sun. These greenhouse gases act like a blanket around Earth, keeping the planet warm enough to support life. Normally, this is a good thing. However, Guy Callender theorized that burning fossil fuels disrupts the natural balance by releasing additional greenhouse gases into the atmosphere. These gases build up in the atmosphere over time, trapping more heat. As a result, Earth's average temperature rises over time as well. Remember, theories cannot be proven without a doubt. They can only be supported or not supported by data. Our job, as scientists, is to see if there is evidence supporting this theory. Are you up for the challenge? Let's break Callender's theory down into three different parts. If we wanted to analyze data to investigate this theory, which part would you start with? Pause the video here to record your thoughts. I don't know about you, but before I looked at why Earth's temperature was increasing, I would want to find data that indicates that the temperature is actually going up. Take a look at this graph of Earth's average temperature over time. What do you notice? In the last 175 years, Earth's temperature has risen by about 1.7 degrees Celsius, or 3 degrees Fahrenheit, a rate of change consistent with Callender's estimates. But we can also use other data sources to support these findings. For example, the area of ice caps at Earth's poles. When Earth warms, ice melts, and we can measure the change in area using satellites. And as ice melts and enters the ocean, sea levels rise, which we can also measure. No matter how you look at it, the data is clear. Earth has been warming over the past few centuries, but there's still more of Callender's theory to look into. We've already seen data that supports Callender's claim that Earth is warming. But why? Let's look at Callender's theory again. What data should we review next? Pause and record your ideas in your guided notes. We'll need data showing the amount of greenhouse gases in Earth's atmosphere over time. Take a look at this graph. If we compare this data to the average global temperatures from earlier, what do you notice? As carbon dioxide concentrations have increased over time, average temperatures have as well. Scientists call this a correlation. This is pretty strong evidence linking rising greenhouse gases to warming temperatures. But Callender went a step further. He believed that burning fossil fuels was leading to increased greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. If you wanted to investigate this part of Callender's theory, what kind of evidence would you need? Probably data on greenhouse gas emissions, specifically how much carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases humans release by burning fossil fuels. Looking at this graph, what do you notice? Greenhouse gas emissions have increased dramatically over time. That makes sense when you think about it. Fossil fuels power much of modern life, from transportation to home lighting to smartphones. As the global population has grown, so has the demand for energy and fossil fuels. Now, let's take a closer look at the relationship between the greenhouse gases we release and the amount that builds up in the atmosphere. If I place the graphs side by side, what do you notice? Once again, there's a strong correlation. As fossil fuel emissions go up, the concentration of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere goes up as well. And as those greenhouse gas levels rise, so does Earth's average temperature. All right, scientists, let's check in. Does the evidence so far support Callender's theory? Pause and record your thoughts in your guided notes. The evidence is pretty strong at this point, but we're not quite finished yet. To better understand this mystery, we need to zoom out and look at the bigger picture. Good science doesn't stop at the first answer. It stays open to new evidence and explores every reasonable possibility. That's why scientists have tested other possible causes of climate change, like volcanic eruptions, solar activity, and even cosmic rays. So far, none of these explain the patterns we're seeing. But there is still another possibility to consider. What if the warming we see today is just part of a larger natural cycle in Earth's climate, one that has little to do with human activity? After all, Earth has been around for billions of years, so it makes sense to expect some natural changes in climate over time. But here's the challenge. To see climate patterns over a really long time, we need climate data over a really long time, not just from the past few hundred years when humans recorded it. That might sound impossible, but scientists found a way. By drilling deep into ice at Earth's poles, researchers extract ice cores, long cylinders of layered ice that have built up over hundreds of thousands of years. Trapped inside the frozen layers are tiny air bubbles, preserved samples of Earth's ancient atmosphere. Scientists used these samples to determine concentrations of gases in Earth's past atmosphere. This is data that's been collected on carbon dioxide levels for the past 800,000 years. What stands out to you? You might have noticed that CO2 levels have gradually changed over time. What does this suggest about Earth's natural climate? It tells us that Earth's climate does go through gradual natural changes. But there's another part of this graph that's hard to ignore. See that sharp spike at the end? That's the past 200 years. Scientists, let's consider this. What do you think this data indicates about how humans impact the rate of climate change? Pause and record your thoughts in your guided notes. This data indicates that while Earth's climate does change naturally over time, human activity, like burning fossil fuels, is dramatically increasing the rate of that change. In fact, scientists estimate that Earth is now warming at a rate nearly 10 times faster than it has at any other point in the last 800,000 years. All of a sudden, Callender's ideas were being taken a lot more seriously by scientists and governments around the world. People began to wonder, how will climate change impact us over time, and can anything be done about it? But don't worry, we'll explore these questions as we progress through this unit. And with that, we've wrapped up our lesson on evaluating evidence for climate change. All the evidence we've examined so far supports Guy Callender's theory that human activity, especially the burning of fossil fuels, is increasing greenhouse gases and accelerating the rate of climate change on Earth. Now it's your turn to think like a scientist. In the PDF activities, you'll dig deeper into the evidence and draw your own conclusions about Earth's changing climate. In our next lesson, we'll look into how climate change impacts humans and the world around us. Until then, I'm Caroline, and remember, every choice we make leaves a ripple in the world around us, so don't underestimate the impact you can have. Stay observant, keep asking questions, and I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.